afternoon, there are special moments when people look back and evaluate a life of an era, birthday, class reunion, holidays, and anniversaries. Time is, after all, simple, the stringing together of a number of events, some small, others significant. These events can speed by quickly, but each one can have an effect on the greater whole. A lifetime of seemingly mundane events can pass in what seems like the blink of an eye, until one looks back to examine them and realizes just how much has filled the space. Stay tuned. Coming up next is the Social Security Hotline on CAN TV. Good evening, Chicago. Welcome to another fall edition of Social Security Hotline 21. My name is Rocío Román. I am a CLINSA specialist at the Social Security office here in the Chicagoland area, and I will be your host for today's program. With me in the studio is my guest, Niana Rice, and our phone technicians for today's program is Joanna Barang-Glazer. Niana, please introduce yourself to our viewers.
Hello, thank you for joining us today. My name is Niana. I am a contact representative within the Northwest Chicago field office.
Mm-hmm. Thank you, Niana. So, we want to remind our viewers that you are watching a live interactive call-in program brought to you on CAN TV 21 to discuss Social Security matters. We invite you to call with your questions or concerns. The phone number in the studio is area 312-738-1060. One more time, the phone number here in the studio is area 312-738-1060. And the phone will remain in the bottom of the screen for the rest of the show. And I just let you know that the phone lines are open already. So while we are waiting for our phone calls, we will get started with our topics. Niana, did you know that recently Social Security Administration celebrated its 83rd birthday?
Yes, mm-hmm. That's exciting.
Yeah, but before we get into our topic, we want to make our audience aware of a very serious scheme that is misusing the Social Security Administration customer service line, which is our national 1-800 number, the 1-800-772-1213. Niana, please start off us with some basic information about this issue.
Yeah, that's right, Rocío. Unfortunately, we have had, our claimants have had so many calls in regards to fraud calls. So the acting Inspector General of Social Security, Gail Stallworth Stone, is warning citizens about an ongoing caller ID spoofing scheme. Misusing the Social Security Number Administration, or SSA, national number, to make these calls. Social Security has received numerous reports of questionable phone calls displaying SSA's 1-800 number on a caller ID screen. This is a scam, citizen. Please know this is a scam. It's not real. That is not Social Security calling you. Please, you should not engage these calls. You should get as much information as you can and provide it to your local Social Security office.
Mm-hmm. This report indicates that the calls display the 1-800-772-1213, which is the Social Security Administration National Customer Service Number, mm-hmm. as the incoming number on caller ID. So people usually have accepted these calls, mm-hmm. and they say that the caller identified themselves as a Social Security Administration mm-hmm. employee. In some cases, the caller states that Social Security Administration does not have all the person's personal information, mm-hmm. such as their Social Security number on file, or other callers claims that Social Security Administration needs additional information so the agency can increase the person's benefit amount, mm-hmm. or that SSA will terminate the person's benefit if they do not confirm their information. Mm-hmm. This appears to be an issue that is across the country, since we have received reports that are coming from citizens across the country, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. We want to remind you all that Social Security employee does not contact by telephone or customer service purposes. And in some situations, an SSA employee may request that the citizen to confirm personal information over the phone. However, Social Security employees will never threaten you for information or promise a Social Security benefit approval or increase in exchange for your information. In those cases, the calls are fraudulent and you should just hang up.
Exactly. To wrap up this segment, we want to reiterate that the Acting Inspector General urged citizens to be extremely cautious and to avoid providing information mm-hmm. such as your social security number mm-hmm. or bank account numbers to unknown persons over the phone or internet unless you are certain of who is receiving it.
Right.
If you receive a suspicious call from someone alleging to be from Social Security Administration, you should report that information to the Office of the Inspector General mm-hmm. or OIG at 1-800-269-0271 or online at https://oig.ssa.gov reports. Mm-hmm. And if you need a few minutes, you can copy the phone number for OIG. One again is 1-800-269-0271, and you can do this report over the phone or also online at oig@ssa.gov/report. Okay, Niana, so back to our topic.
If there is anyone in our viewing audience that has a question or comment about suspicious calls from individuals alleging to represent Social Security, feel free to give us a call at 312-738-1060. Again, the number here at CAN TV is 312-738-1060.
Mm-hmm. So going back to our topic, Niana, let's talk about our agency and briefly, what can you tell us, our viewers, about our agency?
So you can receive the retirement. You can receive disability. Social Security also provide applications for Medicare as well. You can also apply for those benefits on our website at www.ssa.gov. That's the fastest and easiest way to apply for the benefits. You can also visit us on the website to also gather more information about the Social Security retirement, disability, and Medicare, as well as Social Security supplemental income. You can create your My Social Security account as well at www.ssa.gov. And on the main screen, Ms. Rocio.
Mm-hmm. Yes, as you can see, here in the screen is the web page for Social Security Administration. Mm-hmm. All the information and a lot more about our agency is here in the website. You can go in and access all the information. It's a very good opportunity also for you to create my SSA account. And here you can file for benefit online for retirement benefit, for disability benefit. You can also file for or enroll on Medicare. If you already create my SSA account, you will be able to change your address, change your direct deposit information. You can print the benefit verification letters, not only the current one, but also for prior years. So it is a very good idea for you to check out our webpage.
Mm-hmm. And just a little background information about the Social Security, America's most successful and domestic program, and is 83 years old this year. Over the decade, every single payment has made a difference, one person at a time. String those payments together, and it is Remarkable what a positive effect Social Security has had on our economy and society. Social Security was established to help older workers support themselves in retirement. Today, Social Security is much more than a retirement program. It provides benefits to workers who become disabled, as we discussed, and to families when a worker dies. In so many ways, Social Security benefits America.
Exactly. And as you may know, mm-hmm. one of the biggest workload that our agency have is just processing mm-hmm. Social Security cards. Mm-hmm. For this reason, I thought we will have a fun topic today that informs our viewers about a Social Security number and, of course, the Social Security cards. Mm-hmm.
That is right, Rocio. To start, the purpose of the those 9-digit Social Security number, it is to help us maintain an accurate record of your wages or self-employment earnings that are covered under the Social Security Act, and to monitor your record once you start getting Social Security benefits.
Mm-hmm. So let's talk a little bit about why it's so important to have those Social Security numbers.
So say you're working and you want to file taxes, or say you're working in general, Social Security numbers, they help you get a job and to collect Social Security benefits and receive some other government services. However, you do not often need to show your Social Security card. Do not carry your Social Security card with you. Keep it in a safe place. Only carry it with you when you need it. And as soon as you're done using it, you should definitely put it back away. Don't want to get any identity theft. So it's really good to keep your Social Security card in a safe place. But it is also a good tool because everything is logged under Social Security credit, work earnings, filing taxes, so on and so forth. So, you do need a Social Security card, a Social Security number, pretty much for everything these days.
Exactly. Mm-hmm. And what should we do if we need a Social Security card and we don't have it on hand?
Okay.
If it's in its place, or mm-hmm. you know, we're gonna find it.
So if you want to surpass the lines and don't want to wait in the office, you have to work, life happens, you can go on our website at socialsecurity.gov and create your My Social Security account. And you would click on the website, and you would click on the My Social Security. Usually it's at the bottom where you see My Social Security. Uh-huh. And then you can read up on it. Once you read up on it and you want to create your account, you can go ahead and create your My Social Security account. Once you're in your Social Security account online, you can then replace your Social Security card online. However, you would need valid documentation, driver's license, state ID, or passport. Cannot make any changes to your address, your statuses, if you want to update your status, citizen to permanent to citizen, or so on and so forth. You would not be able to do that online. However, if you just need to replace your card and there's no name changes or any other changes on your Social Security number, you can change it via your My Social Security account. And those are the states that also allows you to replace your Social Security cards, where Ms. Rocio is displaying there. Those are the states where you can actually replace your Social Security card. So that's a good tool.
Exactly. Thank you so much, Nana.
You're welcome.
We want to remind our viewers mm-hmm. that you are all watching at Social Security Administration on CAN-TV. And if you have any questions, you can call us at 312-738-1060. And our phone lines are open. Mm-hmm. So let's continue with our topic. So what if the person is not a U.S. citizen, mm-hmm. or they just move, or they don't have an current document mm-hmm. as one of the ones that you mentioned. They have to go to the Social Security office?
Yes, you would want to visit us in your local Social Security office, or if you want, you can send your documents into your local office. Make sure you send originals. We do not accept any photocopies, so you would have to send your original documentation. However, if you do not want to send it via mail. You can visit your local Social Security office with your name change. If you're doing a name change, marriage certificate, and a valid ID. Or if you don't have a U.S. passport or driver's license or state ID, you can use alternative identification if you don't have primary, which is a certified medical record, depending on your age. If you're 5 years and under, a parent who's applying for a child, you can use a certified immunization record. We also accept, if you're military, military ID, life insurance policies. You can call into your local office to just check to see what identification we can use in order to replace a Social Security card if you don't have a driver's license, state ID, or passport. But yeah, if you want to come in and you don't have those three documents for your online account, you can totally come in and apply for your Social Security card. Also, with the My Social Security account, you cannot apply for a child under the age of 18. So if you need to replace a minor Social Security card, you must come into the office or send the documents.
Exactly. Via mail. And another issue that is very important for you to know is that if you recently or if at any point you became a U.S. citizen and you haven't updated your status with us, please take the time, go to your local office with proof of citizenship. Usually it could be the naturalization certificate, the citizenship certificate, or the U.S. passport, and update our records. A lot of our claimants think that once they become a U.S. citizen, our systems update automatically, and that is not true. You have to come in with proof of your citizenship status, and we have to update the your status, your immigration status with us. Now, just to keep in mind, the Social Security number, once is assigned to a person, it won't change. So the only thing that is going to happen is that we are going to change the status, and in most cases we are not going to send a new Social Security card unless you request that, because the number is not changed. Of course, we will issue a new card if there is any change done at the time of become a U.S. citizen. Usually it could be the last name, perhaps in some instances. In cases like that, yes, we will send a replacement card. But if it's just to update the citizenship status, no other change done, then no, you are not going to receive a replacement Social Security card. And talking about the replacements, I want to remind you that in our rules, the maximum amount of replacements cards that can be requested within 1 year is 3, and no more than 10 in a lifetime. So please be aware of that. After 10 replacement Social Security cards has been made, unfortunately we cannot send any more cards. So please be aware of, take care of your Social Security card, not only because of identity theft, but also because at some point you will not be able to get a new one. Okay, so what else we can you can tell us about Social Security Administration?
So say you're ready to retire and you're not too sure that you actually want to. You just want to gather more information about how much you receive with your retirement benefit. You would definitely go visit us online at www.ssa.gov. And you can go ahead and click the retirement estimator. That just estimates how much you would receive. It's not exact, it's just an estimated amount. Just so you can have an idea if you want to, if you want to prolong it, hold off on it, or if you want to go ahead and apply for the benefit. Also, if you do the estimator and you say, well, that may be what I want, I maybe want to retire, you can apply online. You would click the retirement tab. It literally takes you through the application. It shouldn't be too long, 20, 30 minutes max. And then you would get a receipt page. That receipt page just lets you know you finished applying online, and we will reach out to you. So it's not like you're applying online and you know you don't know what's going on after the fact. We will reach out. A representative from Social Security will contact you just to go over the application, what you put in, making sure all the information is as accurate as you want it, as it's supposed to be. And if you have additional questions about your amounts you'd receive, so on and so forth. If you open up your My Social Security account and then you apply for your benefit, you also can see where it is in the process. If it's pending, if it has processed, how much you'd receive, when you receive it. It also have, if you want to update your address, telephone number, direct deposit information, you can do that in the comfort of your home. You don't have to come in. And that would save you time and you can enjoy your retirement without seeing it.
Exactly. As we have mentioned through the program, you can file for retirement benefits online. You will save a lot of time. We are going to review the your application. Mm-hmm. If we need additional information, we will be contacting you. Usually it will be by email or by mail. If you need to come into the office, please do it with the original documents also. Our recommendation is before you apply online for benefit, retirement, disability, or Medicare, please register, create my SSA account. That will ease the steps, the process, and will avoid additional visits to the Social Security office. Unfortunately, at this time, there are a lot of scam scenes out there. There's also a lot of fraud. All our information is being compromised. So it's just an attempt for Social Security Administration to protect everybody's identity and benefit. Sometimes we are requesting additional way to verify the information. But if you register online for My SSA, it will ease the process. And in addition, now that I just mentioned the fraud, if you are a victim of identity theft, our recommendation is for you to contact the three credit bureaus. I'm going to put the information on the screen. The three credit bureaus are Equifax, TransUnion, and Experian. The phone number for the bureaus are Equifax 1-800-525-6285, TransUnion 1-800-680-7289, and Experian 1-800-397-3742. So one more time, if you think you are a victim of identity theft, or if your wallet was stolen, you had in there your Social Security number, you have your Medicare, your old Medicare card, or any information that may be used to become a victim of identity theft, please contact the three credit bureaus and let them know what is going on. Okay. And if you have any question, of course, you can call us here in the studio, area 312-738-1060.
So in regards to also applying online, say you create your My Social Security account, which is also very recommended. If there are years that you're missing in your earnings, you look at your earnings statement, you see like, oh wait, I have a year or two missing, or I know I made this amount that year, but it's not showing. You can then bring it into the office, whether it's a W-2, you work for an employer, or you're self-employed with your schedule SE and C. We can update your earnings record. Now, the self-employment has to be filed within 3 years, 3 months, and 11 days.
15 days.
Yeah, 15 days. But if it's in the time frame, yes, we can add your self-employment or your W-2s. If your date of birth is off, we can go ahead and correct it with an original birth certificate. So the My Social Security account is very helpful for you all.
So, Niana, we realize that many of our viewers still like to conduct their business in person. Our local offices are open daily from 9 to 4 o'clock, with exception on Wednesdays that any Social Security office closed at noon. And I believe this is all for today.
So
on behalf of our hotline team, Rocío Román, your host, my guests, Niana Rice and Joanna Varanglaser, our phone technician. Thank you for joining us today for this edition of Social Security Hotline 21. We wish each of you a very pleasant and safe evening, and be sure to tune in again next Thursday for another edition of the Social Security Hotline. Good night.
Good night, everybody.